Well, we mentioned earlier a report that said that some jobs may be moved from Smucker's in Meadville. On a positive note here this morning, there is a job fair coming up, and we're going to learn more about that as we welcome these guys into the studio this morning. Double Trouble. You guys look like trouble this morning. Why don't you introduce yourselves?
Hey, I'm Clay Kirkland. I'm the plant manager for Homerwood here in Titusville.
Morning, Clay.
I'm Mike Wunderling. I am the EHS and mill manager for the plant, also at Homerwood.
All right. Well, tell us, before we get into the job fair, tell us a little bit about Homerwood. Clay, why don't you take that one?
Yeah, so Homerwood is a company that's been here in Titusville for 34 years. We manufacture the finest premium hardwood floors sold in America. We manufacture over 1,000 different products and distribute to customers all over the country. Some of our biggest customers are actually in Colorado and California. We manufacture solid hardwood, 3/4-inch hardwood, what a lot of people think of as real hardwood. We also manufacture engineered hardwood flooring, which can be installed over concrete slabs, which is a really growing market. We manufacture all of our floors to order, which is very unique for flooring manufacturers. There's a lot of manufacturers maybe manufacture a couple hundred different products and keep them in stock. We manufacture every order to order. So a family walks into a flooring retailer and says, we want, 350 square feet of 8-inch wide smoked white oak floor for our house. And we'll actually go through our entire production process and make that floor with that family in mind.
Really?
And on many of our floors, we actually include a heritage plank, we call it. It's a plank that's engraved with the family's name or some motto that they like.
That's pretty cool.
Yep. So we're part of Armstrong Flooring. Armstrong is the world's largest wood flooring manufacturer. It's a 160-year-old company, and they purchased Homerwood 12 years ago. And their motto is "Let the buyer have faith." And so, in terms of how we deal with each other and with our customers and with our products, everything we do, we look at it with an eye to what's right for the consumer and that family. Mind.
This is such a great story, Mike. This was a company, Homerwood, that was started locally,
right,
and
right,
just
John.
And just grew and grew and grew. And as you mentioned, Clay, purchased 12 years ago by Armstrong. But that part of it, they didn't come in and change that philosophy and that hard work that you guys had this whole time.
No, that was something that they always wanted to keep true to Homerwood and that uniqueness to it. For me, for being there I've been there 17 years now going on.
Wow.
And, I've seen a lot of change and all positive, a lot of really innovative changes too, to the market and everything. But still, all that unique little mom and pop shop kind of stuff there. We're owned by a big company, but we have that final nice, hometown touch to it.
Mm-hmm. And Clay, it sounds like the customers appreciate that.
Yeah, they do. We were actually just about a month ago, we were given an award by Floor Covering News, which is a trade publication that covers our industry, as the best manufacturer in our category for our size, which was voted on by retailers across the country.
And that was the same magazine that as a young boy, Mike would sit in his room at night.
Right. Yeah, probably so. The sheets. Through it, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All the time.
Yeah. But it's great to get that recognition and know that the things that we're doing here in Titusville are being translated through in effects that our consumers are seeing around the country.
Now, Clay, you said you stepped into this role a couple years ago?
I did, yeah. I've been with Armstrong a little over 3 years, about 3.5 years. And about 2 years ago, I was asked to come to Titusville and manage this facility for a couple of months during an interim period, a transition period. And I came here and I really fell in love with the town. I love the community and love the product. I've been in hardwood floors for about 15 years, and they were the most beautiful floors that I had ever seen and the best group of people making them. And so I actually asked if I could stay in Titusville and move my family up here. I've got a daughter that's 6.
Oh, wow.
And a son that's 3. And my daughter just finished her first year at ECLC, which was a great school with Miss Robbins and Miss Finland. And just can't say enough about this community and how much we've enjoyed it here. And I really think the sense of community that we all have here translates through into how we make our product and how we take care of our customers, that we're all going to look out for each other and do what's right in the long term, both for the business and for the community.
It's amazing when you talk about some of these companies around. Yeah, they have that local market they sell to. Mm-hmm. You mentioned, was it Colorado mm-hmm. and California right. as a big marketplace? Well, when you think about that California marketplace, there's a lot of celebrities who have purchased product from here, which yeah. is kind of a neat mm-hmm. thing.
Yeah. Yeah, we just, Mike Zimmer, the head coach of the Minnesota Vikings, we just did about 6,000 square feet in a lake house that he built.
Wow.
Mike, some of the other jobs we've done over the years.
Joel, we've had a little cottage in Canada for Joel, you know, we've done some flooring for her. We've had countless people that we've done. Actually, one was a estate in New Jersey, Alpine Estates. We had done thousands and thousands of feet of 6-inch and 4-inch black walnut, and they were like 4 to 12-foot long planks that they were making herringbone cuts for that, you know, and it was just like, you know, so the product that we're making is just not, you know, a product that you'll find in a, you know, Lowe's or home, you know, or some
big box store
in that, you know, that's going to these multi-million dollar homes in that, in to a lot of bigger well-known people.
Yeah. So it really, it's a product. I mean, and people shouldn't be scared by, you know, that fact either. There's a lot of smaller homes that have beautiful
yeah.
woodwork.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, yeah.
So yeah. Really, it's a product that is accessible to anybody. What's that process for ordering? Is that something they visit you guys or they go online?
So, yeah, there's two ways. We do sell locally from the facility here in Titusville, our overruns. So we usually have a small stock of things that may be seconds for maybe a color issue. Mm-hmm. We do sell those right out the door to consumers. For everything else, so we sell through what's called independent retail. So mom and pop flooring stores around the U.S. We've got over 1,500 locations around the country that wow. we sell through. Each of them purchases through a regional distributor. So we sell directly to a distributor. We have about 10 around the country, and then they service all of the retailers in their area.
So that's an impressive network that mm-hmm. you guys have built over the years. All right, so let's get to the job fair that's coming up. Talk mm-hmm. about, I guess, when is it and where is it?
Okay. Our job fair is going to be this Saturday morning. It's going to be from 8 to noon at our plant in Titusville, 1026 Industrial Drive. We are behind the new Tractor Supply. If you're not familiar with where we are, that'll kind of get you in the area. We'll have signs up front to direct people. We encourage everybody to come by. Everyone who shows up will be interviewed. We're looking to hire about 12 positions right now.
Wow.
We have historically gone through a temporary manning service. As you guys know, our statewide unemployment rate's now down close to 4%. And that's about as tight a labor market as we're probably likely to see here. So we've decided that we need to change our model and look at hiring our employees directly. So people can come in. We'll do interviews, two-on-one interviews with people. They'll have an opportunity to fill out an application. If people are not able to attend the job fair but would still like to apply, they can go to the armstrongflooring.com website and click on careers, and they'll be able to follow through and find the openings that we have here in Titusville and apply that way as well. But of course, we'd love for people to come by and meet Mike and I and the other members of our leadership team and get an opportunity to get to know them and understand what their skills are.
Mike, what sort of what caliber of people are you looking for? Do they need to have any sort of training or what?
You know, we've taken people that have just got out of school that never worked in manufacturing ever, you know, in a day in their life. We've taken those, you know, to me, some of the best people are people that can multitask, waitresses and bar backs, anybody that has that skill of servicing multiple people. But again, we go from just out of high school, but then we do have technical jobs out there that we're looking for, setup equipment, maintenance, you know, so we have a very broad range of people we're looking for. So I wouldn't just set it to one caliber, you know, like we're just looking for someone to run a piece of equipment. We're looking for multiple different mm-hmm. opportunities for people to come in, you know, so definitely anybody, you know, to come in, you know, that from any background, you know.
And what's kind of exciting about this is it's not just, you know, one or two jobs. You're mm-hmm. seeing up to possibly 12 positions.
Yeah, we have positions on first shift. They start at 10:15 an hour. We also have positions on second shift, which would be first shift runs from 6 a.m. to 2:30. Second shift is going to run from 2 p.m. to 10:30 at night. The second shift position started $11 an hour. We're looking for, as Mike mentioned, both people who can be material handlers, forklift drivers, people who can learn how to set up machines, match colors, some maintenance skills needed in the plant. So just hopefully something that people who are first and foremost want to work safe. That's the most important thing to Homerwood. We want our employees to go home at the end of the day as good as or better than they came in. And Mike invests a tremendous amount of his time and his personal time in the safety of our employees. And so that's first and foremost. We really preach that. Secondly, we want employees who want a career, who take their job seriously. You know, our product passes through a minimum of 14 different sets of hands on the way from the lumber shed into the box. And so each step along that chain, an employee has an opportunity to make a decision if the board they're looking at meets their customer's expectations. And so to do that, people really have to be serious about their work and really committed to making sure that what they pass to the next person downstream meets the customer's expectations, because ultimately if everyone does that, then what the customer gets is going to be good, really good product.
How has the market changed? I know you said that this is going to be more hands-on hiring for you guys, but we hear all the time that today that environment for hiring folks is changing. Companies are finding out they have to do a little bit more maybe to attract some of those people to come in and work, and whether it's picking somebody up because they don't have a vehicle or additional training. Have you found that you guys have had to make some adjustments over the years to bring in, you know, the type of caliber of people you're looking for? And what I mean by that is, I should probably change that. Obviously, you're not going to necessarily find, you know, that person who's going to know everything when they come in. But the character of that person, you're going to probably understand fairly quickly on in the process. Somebody you can look at and say, boy, yeah, we can, with the right training, this person's going to be great.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, as Mike mentioned earlier, people don't necessarily have to have any hard set of skills. You know, they have to have the maturity to work in a team. From there, we'll train them in everything that they need to know. You know, even the safety training, Mike does that, and another
EHS Stewart, you know, that we have.
EHS Stewart, Betty Allen at the plant, trains a lot of people. But when it comes to the hard skills, we'll train people in all of that. We have vendors that will allow our employees to come to their sites and train. We have a network of plants, Armstrong plants, that obviously that we're a part of, that people can go to and train. So that people really don't need to be to shy away just because they've never worked with wood or they've never run a woodworking machine before.
This is the Morning Drill on Stream Television, Armstrong, and the Allegheny News Talk Sports Network. Talking about a job fair that's coming up this Saturday. What do folks need to bring with them? Resume?
Yeah, a resume is nice. If they don't have one, that's okay. We would prefer that they do. That just gives us an opportunity to get to know them faster and better. But the main thing is bring themselves and bring an ID and you know, an open mind and willingness to talk to us and let us know who they are.
Now, how much time should they set aside for the whole process? I mean, if they come in with that stuff in hand,
what? We're anticipating 30 to 45 minutes total. Yeah.
It must be exciting to kind of put this together. I know Mike, when he called, and I think I ran into you, last week, trying to get you guys scheduled, there's that excitement of, hey, you know, we're a local company, we're hiring. This is a pretty cool thing. Because it's a local company, that doesn't mean just, you know, in the immediate area. I mean, you have people that come in from all over Northwest Pennsylvania.
Yeah, we do, Mike. Do you want to speak to?
We have people that comes from that are coming in from Franklin, Oil City, Meadville, you know, even Spartans, you know, outlying programs. So they're not just within Titusville. You know, right now we're currently about 100 people right now, and we're looking to increase that. You know, so going through that, you know, I've always had probably 30% of the people that are driving from out of town. You know, it's hard to find, you know, good jobs. We have a lot of good people that work there. We have a lot of people that work there 20 years. You know, I'm going on 17 years, and you know, so I mean, probably over 60 something percent of the people have been there, you know, 5 to 20 years. So we have got a lot of longevity.
So it's a great company to work for.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, Luke, one of the things that we offer that I think is fairly unique is our comprehensive benefit package. We offer health insurance, vision, dental, short-term disability, long-term disability. We offer paid vacations. We offer paid holidays, including the first day of buck season as a paid holiday for Homerwood.
Actually, you go Thanksgiving to Black Friday, and then the weekend, then first day of buck. So you have 5 days, you know, right there. Yep. I mean, that's like that's the selling up. Point right there.
That's coming up.
Yeah.
That's
right. Yep.
Clay, obviously that means you guys are busy. It's not like things are slowing down for you that you're hiring. You're hiring because you're very busy. What's going on in that market? I mean, are people saying, boy, you know, having a hardwood floor is beautiful and something that's going to last over time?
Yeah, you know, if you watch these the home and garden channels and the home improvement channels, nobody ever walks into a house and says, oh my gosh, look at these beautiful carpets. You know, look at this beautiful tile floor. You know, they say, oh my gosh, look at this beautiful hardwood.
Right.
And I think, in the early 2000s, families at a macro level were in the habit of moving into a house, staying there for a couple of years, and moving into a bigger house. I think what we've seen overall in America is that people are staying in their houses longer. And rather than invest in a bigger house, they're investing in sprucing up the house that they live in now. And so there has been a general trend towards hardwood, away from carpet in the U.S. over the last 10, 15 years.
Plus, it seemed like you had with the spike in oil, obviously that affects a lot of, the plastic type things and carpeting, I know, was in there where some of that had skyrocketed.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, wood is, it's competitive if you look at the length of time that you're going to get out of the floor. All of our floors carry a 50-year finish warranty.
Wow.
So you can install the floor and you can expect that you're not going to have to spend much on it for the next 50 years unless you drop a refrigerator or something on it. You know, you can't damage them that way, but you're never going to wear through the finish, basically. So people are willing to invest that extra money in their homes.
One thing, you know, what we talked about, things have changed for us. The things that have changed is, for 30-something years, we were all solid flooring. Just last year, we put in the money to start making engineered product. And it's a sliced veneer that we put on top of plywood, you know. So we can go now to more of the southern states where the hardwood wasn't being used as much because of putting hardwood on slabs is unheard of most of the time, you know, so you can use laminates or, engineered products so that it soaks in that moisture, you know, and not cupping the floor. So within the last year, we just put in the operation of our engineered plant, and it's really doing good, and we're really taking off with that. And that's kind of the spike in some of the numbers that we're looking at and seeing that we need employees and that. So with us, you know, the change of that for us is going more into some of that of the engineered product, but we're still sell a lot of
but that's still a high quality product.
Oh yeah, it is very much same application, same everything, same handling and care that we're doing with everything else.
And once they're installed on the floor, you can't distinguish a solid wood floor from an engineered wood floor. As Mike had mentioned earlier, the engineered wood floor just allows you to be more dimensionally stable, either on concrete slabs, which are going to give off more moisture as the home ages, than a wood subfloor would. And they're also good for environments where you have more swings in humidity. Mm. So in the south, where I'm from, where it gets really humid in Georgia, places out west where it gets really dry at times, the engineered wood floor can absorb those changes in humidity without correlating to a change in the dimension of the product. And so it's going to look better year round than a solid wood floor in a very volatile environment.
That has to be a pretty exciting market to go after then.
It is. Yeah. It's really opened doors up for us. It's allowed us to focus more on commercial type jobs, even though our primary bread and butter business, as I talked about earlier, is consumer business, selling to homeowners. A new emerging business for us is commercial markets. So selling to high rise buildings and large commercial contract jobs. And the engineered wood floor is perfect for that because nobody wants to install 50,000 square feet of solid hardwood and then in December when it gets dry, have it shrink a little bit and everyone notice it at the shopping mall, for example.
Right.
Yeah, so those markets really lean towards engineered wood floors because they know that when they lay it down, it's going to look good year round.
What's the process? I know you guys work with distributors, and once somebody buys your product, is there any aspect where you guys interact with the person who bought it, even though there's somebody mm-hmm. that's in between you guys, or is it pretty much just the feedback you get from distributors or from those small mom and pop businesses that are selling your product?
Well, you know, we do get feedback. We actually had sometimes people request to come watch, you know, their floor and be made and that
really?
Before. Mm-hmm. So we do interact with a lot of the customers and that at times. You know, our sales people and our sales reps will come in and have different tours or different things. But, yeah, so we do interact. So it's not just segregated off and that we don't communicate. No.
So there's a lot of...
There's a lot. And yeah. actually, we do a lot of custom samples. So there's a lot of communication that happens sometimes with them also.
All right, you guys, Job Fair is this Saturday. What time?
It's this Saturday, the 28th, from 8 a.m. to noon at 1026 Industrial Drive here in Titusville behind Tractor Supply.
All right, good luck.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, that's exciting that you guys are growing like that.
Yep.
Congrats.
Yep, thank you.
Thanks
come
back and
up,
come back and update us on what's going on up there.
Okay, we will.
All righty, thanks, guys. News is next.